Hi, I'm a poor student, and today I got this new fish. I think it's called pike. The guy at the store said it was kike, but I think it's pike. And you can tell by the spotty skin there. And so the reason I picked this today was just because it was the freshest looking fish at Haymarket, and you know, this spot was nice and red when I was there. So anyway, I stored it in the fridge, and I just took it out a couple minutes ago. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to marinate this in a bit of hot sauce. And this is just black pepper. Just get that right on there. And instead of salt, I like to use soy sauce, just because it spreads out a lot easier. So I just like pour it on like that. Maybe this should go on first, I don't know. That way the pepper will have something to stick on, I guess. So I'm going to try and get that under the fish as well, so that I don't have to put two helpings of the soy sauce on there. And the other ingredient I like to use is Frank's hot sauce. I ripped off the label, so you just have to trust me that this is Frank's hot sauce. And so I just pour some of that on. And so all I'm going to do is put it on the other side as well, and get some black pepper on there as well. Now it seems kind of weird to have black pepper and Frank's hot sauce, because that's hot and hot, right? But the thing is, black pepper has a bit of a different flavor than the peppers that are used in Frank's hot sauce, which is some kind of aged cayenne pepper, I think. And there's a bit of vinegar and other things in Frank's hot sauce. So there's that. And all I'm going to do is I'm going to put this on a toaster oven tray, put it in the toaster oven for about 10 minutes and see what happens. I've actually never cooked this kind of fish before, so I'm hoping for the best. The other thing I wanted to show you today is mushrooms. I got these great mushrooms from Haymarket. These are oyster mushrooms. I actually had to tell the guy that these are, he put the sign on the wrong box. He actually put the sign on the baby bellas. And I said, no, these are oyster mushrooms. And these were $2 a pound, which is a pretty good deal. And these are shiitakes. And usually if you go to an Asian market, they sell them dried. But they had them fresh at Haymarket, and these are $4 a pound, which seems like a lot for Haymarket, but the thing is, if you go to a regular supermarket, these are about $10 a pound. So, that's a pretty good deal. And these are some red chili peppers from my plant in my on my balcony, so they were free. And I might actually put some of those on when I put the fish in the toaster oven for extra flavor. So I'll just chop those up and sprinkle them on the fish as well. And maybe a little bit of garlic, I haven't decided yet. I put the fish in there, and I put it on top of a bed of those mushrooms and a bit of basil with the chili peppers like I was talking about. And sprinkled a bit more soy sauce on there just to give it a bit more moisture so that the mushrooms don't dry out. And I'm going to try and bake it at 350. And I'm just going to set it for about 8 minutes on the first side and then see how that goes. And then flip it and bake it on the other side. Alright, see you in a few. Looks like baked just on one side. I'm going to try and put these mushrooms underneath the fish when I flip it over. Because, again, I don't want them to dry out. Okay, so let's take a look at this. And you can see it's kind of raw on the bottom. So what I might do now is instead of baking it, I might just use a broil function, because the top seemed to be pretty done already. And what needs to happen is that this part, the top part of the fish, needs to get cooked. So I'm going to try the broil function this time around, and I'll just do it for another 8 minutes, and we'll see how it is. Alright. See you in a few. Okay, I just pulled this out of the toaster oven, and after 8 minutes on the broil function, and it looks like it's done. You can really smell the mushrooms, and mushrooms aren't dried out. The shiitakes especially look pretty good. I don't know about these oyster mushrooms, but you know, we'll try them. So let me try one of these. That's alright. That tastes pretty good. Tastes like a mushroom to me. And the shiitakes. That's pretty well done too. Okay, so I'm going to cut this into the fish. It's actually a little raw in the middle, so I'm actually going to put it back in the toaster oven for another maybe 5 minutes, and we'll come back. Okay. Okay, so after 5 more minutes in the toaster oven on the broil function, it seems to be much better. And I think it's actually perfectly cooked. So this is seems to be a flaky fish. So I'm just gonna give it a little try here. Wow, that is pretty good. Okay, so there you have it. I'm the poor student, and this has been cooking pike fish in the toaster oven.